What's up, guys? And welcome to another edition of
Brad and Paulus. We're laughing because seven nil against Norwich. Welcome to our match review and player watch. So, Zane, I told you it was going to be 3-0, didn't I?
Yeah.
Times two, add one. So you got it right, 3 times 2, add 1, equals?
7-0,
what a performance by the boys. Okay. I said don't get complacent for Norwich, but we should have got complacent, shouldn't we? Because Norwich are not very good at all. Yeah, so this was... this was the first time I think this is our biggest win since we beat Arsenal 6-0.
No.
And Mo Salah was at our club.
What do you mean since?
We beat Arsenal 6-0, didn't we? And Mo Salah was at the club then. So yeah, so Arsenal, that unenviable record is now goes to Norwich.
You're lucky, Elijah.
So that's our biggest win now for a while. So anyway, we're going to focus on two players. Player watch is going to be focusing on Mason Mount, Mr. Hatchet Man. And Callum Hudson-Odoi, he could have been Mr. Two Goal Man, but one was given to the other guy. They should have given it to Hudson-Odoi, shouldn't they? It's embarrassing enough, wasn't it? So anyway, hat trick for Mason Mount. So Mason Mount, we were missing Lukaku and Werner. I wonder what would happen if Lukaku and Werner were playing today. Probably been about 5-0, because Werner could have been at least 5-6. So.
Yeah. Our wingers did most of our work.
So we were quite fluid, but Havertz wasn't in the game, wasn't he? Strange one. He was getting brushed off the ball a lot. Lukaku would have filled his boots today, I think, if he had played. But anyway, we're calling on our strikers to our forward line to step up after the injuries to Havertz to Werner and Lukaku.
They did.
And boy, they did. So let's look at... who are we going to look at first? So let's look at Odoi first, actually. Let's touch on Odoi first. Odoi, he played in his preferred position on the right side of the wing. And when he plays there, he always looks so much more comfortable, doesn't he, on that side? So what do you think? Talk to me about his display.
He was doing good dribbling. He was doing good passing. He assisted and scored.
Yeah, so that's all you could do, ask for. I know that wing play assisted, scored, and he assisted too, really, because that was his cross that led to the own goal, wasn't
it? Would he have got this right?
Yeah, because it was his cross. It was his cross, so that's an assist. Yeah. I wonder what fantasy football does put it down. They must put it down as an assist, because But anyway, what I liked about his goal as well, the movement, because what he did, he came short for it, then he went short, then he came back out long again. So the defender was taken out of the game, and it was a great ball by Kovacic, brilliant ball as well, wasn't it? And it was a fantastic direct run by Hudson-Odoi, and the finish was nice and composed, wasn't it?
Well, Norwich did leave their line open. It was like a defender there, a defender all the way across the pitch.
Yeah, it was like opening the Red Sea, wasn't it? Yeah, so...
Victor Moses.
But... Yeah. I like that. Yeah, but the finish was still a very good finish, wasn't it? And like he can do that more often, because I saw him do that time and time again in the youth team, Zane. He was a very good finisher in the youth team. But I think once he's playing in the senior squad, he kind of snatches at those chances sometimes. But he proved this time that he was like, nice, composed finish. Great, it's a great job for him. And, you know, his dribbling was on point. There's only one thing he did. Remember when he lost possession towards the end of the first half? That one chance. I think then it was the ex-Quebec who played for Liverpool last season who shot the ball over. And that's the only time I think that he got a bit sloppy. First half, he was bright and he was in the second. But the second half, he still had some good moments, didn't he? So, well done, Hudson-Odoi. He stood up, he took his chance, so he'll probably be in for the next game. What about Mason Mount then? What's your feeling on Mason Mount?
Again, he was doing good passes. He scored a hat-trick, so... definitely
deserved
man of the match.
Yeah, good goal, first goal, wasn't it? Did it take a deflection, guys?
No, because when we were watching the replay, we saw a foot and it seemed to redirect it. I didn't know it was good timing.
Yeah, I don't know. It was just weird.
It
I don't think it did.
It looked like the foot was closer and the ball was there.
And I was crying out as well. And many times shooting from distance, because we don't do that a lot. But yes, today we did it. He took a shot from outside the penalty box and knocked it in. So great to open up the scoring account. Callum Hudson Odoi made it two, isn't it? I'm losing count of who scored when. So he made it two. Who scored a third? Oh, Reece James. What a goal by Reece James as well.
Good chip.
Brilliant chip. What a fantastic goal just before half time. So that was brilliant. And then second half, it was Ben Chilwell, wasn't it? Ben Chilwell scored a fourth. The fifth was the own goal we've already talked about, touched upon. And the sixth and the seventh were Mason Mount. So the other one, the penalty, first of all, I thought, us saying he's going to miss this because Kroll's got a good record. Because Kroll, at 5-0, we're saying, what's the point of you making all these saves?
Exactly.
He's going to lose anyway. So what's the point of it? Come on, build up our goal difference. You're getting relegated, so, you know. And before we scored those other two goals, you know what? Ben Gibson said he had enough, didn't he? So he decided to get himself sent off. He said, I don't want to be embarrassed any further, so let me just get out of there. So we decided to do a reckless foul on, who was it he fouled? Reece James, yeah. And then off he went. Bye-bye. But, the penalty, and I said he's going to miss this. I just had a feeling he was going to miss, and he did. But should we be worried? Because VAR, first of all, with VAR, why didn't the referee see? I know that Norwich were in trouble, that they probably did need two goalkeepers on the pitch, but literally the defender was acting like a second goalkeeper. And the guy saved it right in front of the referee, and the referee had to have VAR to make that, and he's right in front of him. Come on, where's your eyes, boy? Come on. And VAR came in again and embarrassed him because it was a definite penalty. But then when we thought, oh no, I told you he was going to miss, but then VAR said no, he didn't miss because Kroll was about 10 yards off his line. He was literally touching the penalty spot the time.
He blocked the ball as soon as
it. Exactly. So again, and he nearly saved that one as well, didn't he? Because this time Mount put it straight down the middle, and it hit his knee a little bit, but the power was too much that it went in. And when Mr. Loftus Cheeks came on and he carried on his good work, and very unselfish play, wasn't it? To put the ball on the plate for Mason Mount for his hat trick. Tight, he was just onside, so it was like, is he, please let him get his hat trick. First hat trick for Chelsea in his senior football. So again, round of applause to you, Mr. Mount. And you know what? Let's give a round of applause to Ziyech. When he came on, he was really good, wasn't he? He did some nice, you know, he had that curler which went just wide. He was showing a bit of sauciness, wasn't he? That's the Ziyech I like to see. So, Ziyech, please do that though. Not when we're 7-0 up. You know, when we're in a tight game, show that bit of sauciness as well. Okay, Norwich's defending wasn't great, but, you know, credit due to Mr. Ziyech on his cameo performance as well.
And so, the thing is, I didn't even know which goalkeeper was playing because we never went in a half of the field. I didn't know which goalkeeper was playing. It could have been Kepa.
It could have been.
Actually,
he did make a good save, didn't he? Remember that one with his foot? So, and he didn't want to. That's what I love to see. We're 5-0 up. He wants to keep a clean sheet. So he said, you know what? You're not getting that consolation. I value my clean sheets. You know, I'm not going to the laundry tonight, mate. My sheets are clean. So he just said, you know, it's all sorted. So Mr. Mount rightly got the man of the match, but anyone could have got man of the match today because everyone was good. Rudiger, I thought, was exceptional. Reece James was
really
good.
Rudiger kind of got an assist.
Yeah.
Penalty.
Yeah. Even Chalobah played well. Everyone, you know, the whole team played well. You know, so goal difference as well, 7 goals, so that's good. Still at the top of the league. Big goal difference, and you know, all is rosy in the garden. We got, is it Newcastle next week? Newcastle are a bit of a bogey team, although we beat them last year, so we can't take that for granted. So hoping that we can carry on the good work.
And then Burnley.
So come on, guys, let's keep this run going. And the only thing
our
was
goal difference is 20.
Plus 20. Ooh, yeah.
And Man City and Liverpool are 16.
Yeah, so Man City won today as well, so we'll see. Yeah, but yeah, let's just, it's all, it's everything, it's good in the garden, so let's keep it up, guys. So great. So who was your man of the match? Was it Mason Mount, or were you going to give it to somebody else? What do you think of the performance? Are you happy, guys? Are you confident that we can go on a Mount a title challenge? Mount, get it? A Mason Mount a title challenge, or, we'll see. Anyway, guys, don't forget, as always, saying, send it away.
To like the video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on all post notifications so you'll be notified when we make a video. Share this video and comment down below.
Up the blues. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.